Well, I'm not going chit chat. Let's get to it.
Random Black Guy!
What up, everybody? Alfie here, aka Random Black Guy, aka Chocolate Face No Makeup. And this is a video of why I think Stranger Things Season 3 is the best season ever. I love Stranger Things. I love season one. I think season two was, I think it started good, but it came pretty mediocre by the end. But to me, I think Stranger Things season three nails it. I think this is the best season ever. First of all, I always had a little bit of a problem with the evolution of Will, but in this season, I feel that Will became not only a plot device, but more of a character. We felt who he is. We understood all of the stuff that happens to him in the two first season, why he is pretty much a weapon to use. And I like that evolution of Will. This season the budget is more, is better special effects. The acting is pretty good from everybody. And I think that this nails down the nostalgic feeling that I think that we as a people like with Stranger Things. That's why the season one always has a place in my heart. But I think that season three, it's just better as a show. It's more entertaining. It's doing stuff with these characters that I think that in a way season two just didn't. Another thing that I really, really like with the season is Dustin. I think the last season, Dustin was just more of the comic. Yeah, he was more the funny guy. And I like Dustin. I think that Dustin overall is more than being the funny guy. I think that Dustin is the most curious of the group. He wants to feel that what he's doing is rewarding. And in this season, you just see Dustin's curiosity to the max. And I like that really, really much. I think that Dustin, he was okay in season two, but in this season, he is the standout. He is so good as a character, and I like it a lot. I think that Harrington, the new characters like Lucas' little sister Erica, she can be a little bit of a stereotype, and I had a hard time liking her at first. I was just thinking that she was a little bit annoying. I think that she is really funny and awesome in this. Every episode, she grew on me, and yeah, I know, even though that she can be a little bit like, oh, come on, stop acting this way. She's young. She has to be at least like 8 years old. And that age, every kid is annoying. So I understand why she was the way she was. And I like her a lot. I think she's really, really good. A character I had a little bit of a problem with in the last season is Billy. I thought Billy was so evil in a way that he became a little bit of a stretch. It became a little bit, yeah, he became irritating. He was just evil because of it. Like, I just never felt the reasoning of why he was the way he was. But in this season, I think Billy became he has more of a purpose as a character, because to be honest, I never thought that he would survive in the last season. I thought that he would die like pretty early, but he didn't. He survived, and I was like, okay, what are they going to do with this character? In this season, I think that he is the center of, the center character when it comes to the secondary characters, because he's evil. Like, an alien took him. You know, the Shadow Flayer took Billy, and now Billy, in a way, is the Shadow Flayer. And I like that. I like that way they utilize Billy in this season, because I think that if not, Billy will be pretty much unnecessary as a character. So if you don't know the plot of this season, the season is the year of, I think, 1985, and the new mall of Storkot is actually the local point now, or the local focus of this season. But anyways, Billy becomes captured by the Shadow Flayer, because Shadow Flayer is in the city right now, and he can't use Will anymore. He uses Billy as like the new avatar. Strange powers trigger Will's awareness about it, that something is weird, and Eleven, she starts to sense that something is little bit off about this town. Even though the portal is now closed to the upside down, they still know that something is wrong, because the Shadow Flayer is there now in Hawkins. And after Shadow Flayer takes Billy, he starts to use Billy and a bunch of people as like a zombie in a way. Even though they are still the same, they are puppets of Shadow Flayer. The gangs need to stop Shadow Flayer and everybody from destroying Hawkins. I was a little bit curious of how they're going to take the next step of the gang, you know, but damn it, I think that this plot is just better. I think that by doing the Storkot Mall, the main focus of the place that everything happens, because you see a bunch of Russian people dealing some shady stuff in the mall, and you trying to figure out like why. And man, it just, the more episodes you see, the more you start to like it even more. And that's why I think this season is just better, because I wasn't expecting anything from this season at all, to be honest. I was thinking that this season was going to be either a stinker or okay. It just blew all expectations I had, and I think that it is really, really good. That's why I think this season is the best season yet. Even though season one is always going to have a place in my heart, I think the reference, the nostalgic moments, everything is there. Even to the Russian goon, who is exactly like Arnold Schwarzenegger. People will know what this is about, and all the reference is so good. Everything from the music, of course, to I saw the Day of the Dead thing, I like that, to the clothing lines, and to the food. Everything is just there, and I think that they nailed it so good. They nailed it to the T with this. I don't feel like I felt with season 2 that some of these characters was wasteland. They were just in the background. They were doing something, but not that much. I think people like Max even is doing something in this season. But the only thing I have to critique is that I think that the thing with Jonathan and Nancy, that side plot, it is so boring. I'm sorry, it is that is the most boring plot line of this show. It tends to make me want to see the rest of the gang. I want to see what Jim and Joyce is doing. I want to see the kids, what they are doing. I'm not that interested of seeing Nancy and Jonathan, because I think as a character, they are pretty boring. I think their character arc is just, and some stuff can be a little bit cheesy, and even though it's a little bit like, oh come on, it is, I liked it still. I still liked it, because it's a thing of Stranger Things. You have to take it for what it is, you know, the nostalgia, the music, the science fiction elements is the biggest reason why you love it. And yeah, I know I know that some of the lines they are spewing is a little bit of a head scratcher, but take it with a grain of salt. And that's why I'm pretty excited to see what they're going to do with season 4, because it's the last one. And I think that, yeah, they can do it so good right now, because season 3 repaired everything that was fault with season 2. So if you have the opportunity, see it. It's only 8 episodes. Netflix, I like what you're doing. Yeah, first giving us Dark, now Stranger Things. So Netflix has been on fire this month, man. Yeah, oh my god, they are on fire with this one. Anyways, my rating of Stranger Things season 3, I give it a 4.5 out of 5. Yeah, so yeah, this was mostly a rant by, I think that this season of Stranger Things is the best one yet. Anyways, have you seen Stranger Things season 3? What do you think about it? Write your comments down below and let me know. And don't forget to like and click on the notification bell, so every time I upload a new video, you will be the first to see it. My name is Alfie, aka Random Black Guy, aka Chocolate Face No Makeup. And that was, yeah, my raving of why I think Stranger Things season 3 is the best one yet. Until next time, I'm Givi out there. Peace. Random Black.